Hi, this is Eric Martin with Board Game Geek. I'm here with Claude Amodei from Funforge.
Indeed.
We're looking at Tokaido Namiji, which is a prototype, something coming in the future.
Indeed.
I assume designed by Antoine Bauza.
Indeed.
We are very familiar with Tokaido. You've come out with a number of different editions of it.
Yeah.
Over the years, and now we have a new game.
Indeed. It's Antoine Bauza wanted to follow up on Tokaido.
Mm-hmm.
Still keeping the same kind of mechanics, the same feeling, and the same graphics, by the way, but the same artist, Nayad, but bring something new in the game. So as in Tokaido, the player will have a boat. Here you have different boats. They are all the same. You have no specific design for the player. You place the same boat, and you will travel along a path in the sea to fishes, and to stop at pontoons to do several things. So the mechanic of movement is the same as in Tokaido.
Okay.
This is to say the last player in the row will move first and stand on a space on the road, I would say. And of course, each space will provide different feeling of game, victory point, and so on. I will explain some of them if you want.
Yes.
And you go all along the path, and then arriving here give you victory points also if you arrive first and so on. Okay. So what is new in Tokaido? On this Namiji, sorry. First of all, we wanted to keep something which was very cool, which was the panorama. If you remember, you have panorama.
Mm-hmm.
We keep this with the wells. If you stop at some wells point, you see, you can choose panoramas in order to build, like for Tokaido, you know, a well, which will give you different kind of point, of course.
Right.
Depending on how long you can proceed. Okay, this is the only thing we keep from Tokaido in terms of feeling of design of mechanic of play.
Right.
So here you have you go to fish shrimps, and then you have to take in the bag some shrimps.
Okay.
So randomly, okay, please do.
How many?
One.
Just
by one.
Okay.
And then you have to stop or pursue. It's a crab. So it's 1 point, but if you fish a second crab, then you lose everything.
Okay.
And you have shrimps and crabs. So shrimps, so you lose everything.
Okay.
But you can fish shrimps. I will show you a shrimp. Here it is. So I move on. If I have a crab, okay, I can continue or stop. Keep
but
my
you
2 points.
Build up as much
yes,
as you want.
Yes, indeed.
Okay.
As soon as you have a crab, you lose everything on the spot.
Okay.
Okay?
Yeah.
So this is a wells, I explained. This is a fish place. When you arrive here, you will have to pick up one fish. Okay. And this has to go on your board, starting here. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
And you flip another one. The next player arriving on a fishing point will have the choice to take this one or to pick a new one. But each time, let's say he takes this one, each time he will flip another one.
Okay,
so, and the idea is to have a row or a column of the same color of fish or same shape.
Right.
Okay, and then if you have the same, this is, let's say I got that, and etc. If I have the same shape or same column, I got the victory point at the end of the row of the column.
Okay.
So you have to think about the way you fish, and either to pick one randomly or one which is discovered. Okay. You can also complete this net with this stop, which allow you to take one double fish, same color, same shape. So it helps you. Here, it finished my row. Okay.
Okay. But mystery.
Yeah.
A mystery. You don't know what you're getting.
No, indeed.
That's
indeed.
Right. Works with.
Here you have something very new, which kind of reminds kind of Crossroads, the first extension of Tokaido.
Mm-hmm.
When you arrive on a rock, you pick up 2 cards, and then it's hidden objective.
Okay.
So you will have to consider those objectives when you move along the path in order to count victory point. Okay. This one say, by example, that you have 4 points if you have at least one kind each of one kind of animal. Okay. By example. Yes. And this is hidden, so you reveal it at the end of the game. Okay. This is very new compared to Kaido.
Yes.
And the other one is discarded, of course. So each you may have several as long as you stop in mm-hmm. Secret rocks. When you arrive at the pontons, I don't know, it's a ponton, it's a word in English, where you have your ship waiting.
Like a port?
Yeah, like of this kind of thing.
Yes.
Wow, okay.
A dock.
A dock, yeah, okay. Yes. So when you arrive here, which is something different with Tokaido, you choose which place you will be.
Okay.
In Tokaido, you always sit here and you are the last to play.
You get first choice.
Then you can do what you want, okay?
Okay.
And as in Tokaido, you take as many cards as there is player, okay? Mm-hmm. Let's say we are five, so I take six cards, and I choose one of these, and the other one I put aside, and then the other player will keep, okay?
Right.
The idea is, you will have, you may notice that there is first an effect and a symbol on the stations, which means that when I arrive in this station, something happened, which is always positive, okay? By example, here, if I fish, I can fish another time.
Okay.
Okay. That's, and this you keep it, of course. This is revealed, so every player knows that you have to stop on those station in order to get benefit.
The bonuses.
Yes,
future,
indeed.
Yes.
And so you can have several, of course, as long as five of them, four of them, sorry, as long as you move around around the path.
Okay. We got this.
Yes, oh yeah, oh, this is something very different also in Tokaido. You may notice that in your boat, you start with small paper origami boats, which are negative points, by the way, up to minus 15. You see, so you start with minus 15 points. In order to get rid of those boats, you have to offer it to the gods. Then, when you arrive on a whirlpool, which is Naruto, by the way, you discard one of these, and you put it on the whirlpool.
Okay.
And then, of course, it's less and less point lost at the end of the game.
Okay.
And I think I explained everything. Yeah,
yes.
It's very easy, but quite different from Tokaido, because you have a large range of new effect on station, and you have still the same feeling of having something zen.
Right.
And the same spirit, because it's Nayad who will do the illustration, and a very nice prototype. We were very pleased at FunForge to see Antoine coming with this new Tokaido,
that's right,
which will be released this year in a way or another.
Okay, excellent. I can already imagine the finished art.
Yeah, it's not, it's changed, but the spirit is there. We will change the cover, but the spirit is there.
Yeah, Nayad is beautiful, beautiful stuff.
Indeed, so. He's such talented. Yeah. And we worked for a long time with Nayad. The first time he worked for us was a game called Isla Dorada, a game from Bruno Feduti. He illustrated the card, in fact. And then the big jump in his commitment into gaming was Tokaido, of course, when he designed the first Tokaido, which is so great and helped the game very much, in fact, in terms of feeling.
The spirit of it.
Yeah, the spirit, yes.
Yeah. Absolutely. Well, thank you very much, Claude.
You're welcome.
A review of Tokaido no Miji, coming 2019.